As of the end of 2019, I have ridden 826 steel coasters in 34 different states and 14 different countries. Today, I'm going to count down my top 25 steel coasters in the world. 25. Joker at Six Flags Discovery Kingdom. This isn't the best paced RMC, but the strength of the ejector airtime is better than most RMCs, and I absolutely love that twisting first drop and zero G roll. 24. Mako at SeaWorld Orlando. This is the rare B&M Hyper I actually prefer in the front. Mako's first half is absolute perfection. The airtime is both powerful and sustained. I just wish the second half kept that intensity going. 23. Apollo's Chariot at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. This isn't the most intense hyper coaster, but I love the ride's wooded setting and big drops. If you ride in the back, you'll spend more time out of your seat than you spend in it. 22. Formula Rosa at Ferrari World. The love child of Top Thrill Dragster and Millennium Force is an absolute rush. That launch is truly one of the best in the world. The airtime and forces aren't as intense as other Intamins, but the sense of speed more than compensates. 21. Intimidator 305 at King's Dominion. This is one of the most intense coasters in the world. Everyone is going to gray out in that first turn, and those direction changes are insane. It's crazy to have a giga coaster that hugs the ground as much as I-305. Some may be surprised to see this coaster this low, but I do prefer coasters that focus more on airtime. 20. Flying Dinosaur at Universal Studios Japan. This is the undisputed best flying coaster in the world. This coaster has some surprising airtime combined with some of the most forceful inversions on the planet. 19. X2 at Six Flags Magic Mountain. Whoever thought the fourth dimension coaster is a mad genius. This ride is definitely bouncy, but I'm willing to look past that simply because of how ludicrous this ride is. All those flips is why X2 is the second most intense coaster in the world. 18. Edgenica at Fuji Q Highland. This is the most intense coaster in the world. It's a bigger and badder version of X2. It does everything I love on X2, but corrects the lone dead spot with an intense overbank with a flip. 17. Phantom's Revenge at Kennywood. I love terrain coasters. I especially love the rare terrain hyper. This isn't the longest ride in the world, but has some of the most powerful airtime on the planet thanks to those loose restraints. 16. Twisted Timbers at King's Dominion. I don't miss Hurler one bit. Twisted Timbers is a non-stop barrage of airtime and inversions. It does lose some speed at the end, but it doesn't lose any airtime. 15. Storm Chaser at Kentucky Kingdom. This coaster contains some of RMC's strongest airtime moments. That's true on both the straight hills and the off-axis hills. The airtime just seems more sustained than other RMC's. 14. Twisted Cyclone at Six Flags Over Georgia. While this is one of RMC's shorter coasters, the layout is top-notch. I particularly love that wave turn, and the rest of the airtime hills on the ride also deliver crazy ejector airtime as well. 13. The RMC Raptors. I'm grouping both Six Flags Fiesta Texas's Wonder Woman and California's Great America's Railblazer here. The RMC Raptors feel ridiculously fast and have some of the most powerful airtime on the planet. The one downside, though, is that they're short. 12. Superman the Ride at Six Flags New England. This coaster was once considered one of the best in the world, but it has since started to lose its luster. In 2019, Six Flags New England added new wheels, and Superman now runs better than it has since the mid-2000s. I still believe this coaster has one of the best layouts in the world, and it mixes sustained ejector airtime with quick pops of ejector airtime. 11. Millennium Force at Cedar Point. It's almost fitting this coaster sits next to Superman on this list. Millennium Force is all about the speed. In the front row, this coaster is truly special. And the few airtime moments this ride has aren't too shabby either. 10. Helix at Leesburg. This is easily the highest Mach coaster on this list. While the launches on Helix are admittedly weak, everything else about this coaster is exceptional. The inversions deliver a boatload of hang time, and the airtime hills deliver sustained ejector airtime rivaling an Intamin. Plus, Helix has one of the best settings of any coaster. 9. Skyrush at Hershey Park. This coaster is insane. The ejector airtime is arguably the strongest of any coaster, and the directional changes will try to flip you over into the water. Sky Rush just isn't as rideable as the coasters placed higher than it on this list. 8. Shambhala at Port Aventura. This is the king of the B&M hypers. Shambhala is one gigantic drop after another, and the airtime on those drops is truly world class. It's stronger than your average B&M hyper, and every drop somehow manages to deliver that stomach-dropping sensation I typically only get on a drop tower. 7. Iron Rattler at Six Flags Fiesta Texas. I love coasters with unique settings, and Iron Rattler definitely fits the bill with the quarry setting. This coaster has some very strong airtime and two of the best drops on the planet. I particularly love that twisting first drop. 6. Fury 325 at Carowinds. This is the highest B&M on this list. Like Millennium Force, Fury 325 is all about the speed. Except Fury 325 has much better elements. The first drop is breathtaking, the speed hills are intense, the treble clef feels like something straight out of an RMC, and the finale has some very powerful and sustained airtime. 5. Twisted Colossus at Six Flags Magic Mountain. This coaster is essentially two top 10 rides spliced together into one, and that's perfectly fine by me. Each side is a relentless barrage of airtime, and the dueling is just icing on the cake. 4. Schwerdes Kiernan at Hansa Park. This is the only Gerslauer on this list, and for good reason. Kiernan is one of the most unique coasters in the world. It's rare to have a coaster this intense themed as well as Kiernan. Mix in those surprises in the tower with an aggressive layout filled with ejector airtime and laterals, and you have a truly special ride. 3. Expedition G-Force at Holiday Park. This is an ejector airtime machine. Every single Camelback and Bunny Hill delivers sustained ejector airtime. And when you mix in that heavily wooded setting and a maniacally twisted first drop, you have a ride deserving of all the praise it receives. 2. Untamed at Wallaby Holland. This is essentially a mini Steel Vengeance. This coaster doesn't have a single dead spot, as it's a rapid-paced blitz of airtime hills and inversions. And unlike a lot of the other small RMCs, this one doesn't run out of steam. 1. Steel Vengeance at Cedar Point. Most of you probably saw this coming, but Steel Vengeance is breathtaking. To have a coaster this long and intense is mind-boggling. The first half says some of the best sustained ejector airtime on the planet, and the second half alone would be a top 10 ride in itself. That second half feels like Storm Chaser or Twisted Timbers on its own. Do you agree or disagree with my list? Are you wondering where a certain coaster placed that missed this list? Comment below and I'll be sure to get back to you. Thanks for listening.